So before we begin, this is some house plants that are showing signs and symptoms. Nothing is wrong with it. It's just crying because it's not getting exactly what it wants. This right here, can you see it? It's crying. Once I gave it a new setup, immediately it started growing. So in today's video, darling, we're not talking about when plants cry. We're talking about when orchids cry. Signs and symptoms and things that you can do to improve your growing experience. Stay tuned. So welcome back, Fal Pals. Let me give you some of the reasons why your Phalaenopsis orchid is crying. It's not getting enough light. It's not getting enough water. It's getting too much water. It's not happy with its setup. It's because you just transitioned it from water culture to bark, or from bark to water culture, so it's under stress. Or you're just not giving it enough love and attention by talking to it. So, Fal Pals, I hope that this video will give new parents, new orchid parents, a sense of relief, knowing that after you have your second child, it's like, girl, whatever. Like this video and let me know if this is the type of content that you guys have been looking for. So these Phalaenopsis right here are going to be my examples of typical behavior. You're going to have four different seasons, and in each season, different orchids are going to do different things. But typically, you have a girl, our new flower spike. I didn't even know. So that's a whole different video. But you have leaves, they're firm, they're healthy, they're green. The bottom leaves, you may have one, two at the most, to fall off while it is in spike or bloom. That's okay. This is okay. This is normal. Okay. No blooms are fading or anything. Typical Phalaenopsis orchid. You might even have some that's in bloom that will actually start growing roots and leaves. That is fine. That is what you actually would love and want. This right here is for our winter bloomers. They are now growing roots and growing leaves. Now, orchids that are crying, what are signs and symptoms? What to look for? Because it's a lot with diagnosing your orchids properly. The main thing that we are looking for is an orchid with dehydrated leaves, especially if it's already in water or if you have been watering it. This right here is the case right here for an orchid that is just not happy with its setup. It is not dying. It's letting you know, if you don't get me out of this setup, eventually I'm going to give up on life because I'm not able to thrive. Okay, now there's a difference between that and orchids that just have not been watered. So pay close attention to that. Stay tuned. Another example is going to be your blooms wilting prematurely. This is a Phalaenopsis orchid that I had moved. I tried to emulate the conditions it was already in. Unbeknownst to me, the blooms started to wilt the next day. That's a sign and symptom. Hey, everything is okay with me, but I really want to go back where I already was. Another example is going to be when those beautiful root tips stop growing or even dying back. Because that is letting you know, hey, when it's actively growing, hey, I want to see where I am. When they started spreading out like this, they're like, hey, this is my place. I don't want anyone over here. I'm about to bloom. But once those roots start to die back and dry up after you have moved it specifically, it's going to let you know it wants to go back now. Put me back, mama. So I have to rearrange my shelves just to accommodate my one of my favorite Phalaenopsis orchids. Stay tuned. And welcome on back to a no judgment zone. So please like this video if it helps you. I want to educate you so you can start diagnosing your Phalaenopsis orchids the right way. Everything is not going to be life and death. Okay, so this is just a few examples before I show you the last example, the prime example I believe most new beginners are struggling with. Now, anytime your orchid gets to doing this wobbly in the pot, okay, you see stunted growth, but anytime it gets to wobbling or even falling out of the pot, it just wants to be repotted. You can actually see some acid burn or salt buildup right there. And so it just needs to be repotted. It's letting you know that roots in the pot have died and it needs a fresh setup. That is the first thing before you start seeing bottom leaves starting to fall off like this. You see those two bottom leaves falling off? The orchid is still healthy, it's still just fine, but it's letting you know, baby, I need to be repotted. It's going to be the same example with this Sogo right here. You can see it's just, honey, she just laying down. She wobbling, honey, girl. She'll come right on out if I wanted her to. And that's what I'm talking about. And as you can see, she has leaves falling off. Okay, still pulling nutrients from this leaf and this leaf. And she has a flower spike. So this is an extreme cry for help. Yes, she has a flower spike, but I assure you that the flower display would not be worth anything to show. The same with this Sogo. It fell right on out the pot. It just jumped out the pot. It has a new leaf growing. It has a root growing. I just initiated it into water culture. And so far, so good. It's only been a day. This baby right here, she is growing a new leaf and she's growing all of her roots outside of the water culture method. Okay, so that's an indication that, girl, I'm not trying to be in a water culture. What's wrong with you? So that's all. It's not anything serious. Now, if you get to slicing and dicing and adding herbs and spices, that will cause the Phalaenopsis orchid to go into shock. Okay, stay tuned. All right, Fal Pals. Now, this baby is really what prompted this video. Okay, if you can look, a very healthy Phalaenopsis orchid with big roots. However, the bottom leaves just keeps falling off. This is the third leaf to fall off in my care. And this leaf right here is not coming out anymore. So this is a cry for help, an indication that your Phalaenopsis orchid needs to be repotted. It has outgrown its current living conditions, okay? With the Phalaenopsis orchids, new beginners, if you get it to grow, meaning that it's growing roots and it's growing leaves, if it's growing anything, honey, it's in the right place at the right time. So make sure to let that spot remain, that orchid spot, until it has outgrown it. Now, Fal Pals, I hope that you have a happy growing. Until next time.